Joining us in our cafe all the way from Middle Earth to our South End pier.
Oh, it's only Liv Tyler, everyone!
Love to see you.
Welcome.
Hello, you lovely girl.
I'm so excited to have you in
our... Wow, this is so cool. I don't think I've ever been this far out to sea.
Yeah. You've got your little train up. And, guys, are you excited? This is your waitress and your cook for today.
Yeah.
We're going to have a proper cook-up. How are you? Because you're sort of pretty much living in the UK now, aren't you?
Yeah, I moved here in August.
Yeah.
I fell in love with an English man.
Did you?
And moved to London, yeah.
So there's some amazing pictures here. And, like, kids, oh, my God, so cute. Is that you there?
That's me and my grandmother,
right.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow. Colour coordinating the tops, by the way.
Your dad's squares. Your dad's hair is epic, isn't it?
He's probably going to be mad at me because that was really early in the morning.
But also, the coolest granddad in the world, right? I mean, can you imagine?
But you are a busy mum, haven't you? I mean, four kids?
Yeah, we have four together. Yeah, Milo, Gray, Sailor, and Lula.
And professionally, very, very busy. You've just finished Gunpowder, haven't you?
I did, yeah. So it's about the Gunpowder Plot. And I play this woman who was really quite brave at that time because it was really dangerous. And they were really torturing people and doing horrible things to people.
And you had to perfect your English accent.
Yeah, I've done it a few times before.
Yes.
So I went to see a dialect coach that I'd worked with before on The Lord of the Rings. And it was kind of like riding a bike or something. It just sort of came back. Well, the hardest parts are these, like, sort of the vowel sounds.
Give us a whirl, give us a whirl.
No. I'm so shy. I can say Guy Fawkes.
Perfect.
Well, you can probably talk better English than me and Jimmy. So have you given your English partner a good telling off in English?
No, I don't tell David off in my English accent. I probably sound like a real New Yorker when I'm back.
And, of course, Lord of the Rings, you had to learn Elvish.
Yes.
Which is a real language now.
It is. There was these people that would write in, like, kind of critiquing our Elvish. I remember that, of course, yeah.
And, of course, you spent a lot of time in New Zealand filming.
But the food's really delicious in New Zealand. I was really surprised.
Great
amazing
produce.
Restaurants. Yeah,
great restaurants, amazing fish.
Really, and a little bit of Asian flair.
Yeah, I was
going to
say that. Japanese, Asian come through really nicely, doesn't it?
I love food. I would eat all the time. But weirdly, my favorite thing in the world is just a really good glass of red wine and a bag of potato chips. That makes me so happy.
That is the best thing, isn't it? Especially on holiday.
It's that or on the train home from Gunpowder, I was like, I'm trying to be good. And I was like, I just have to have a bag of crisps.
Yeah.
And I go to the little shop and buy the little mini bottles.
That's the best.
I try as much as possible to cook, especially on the weekend, and have everyone sit down together. And breakfast is kind of my favorite meal to cook because it's just so fun, and pajamas and radio on.
Yeah, love it.
There's so many different flavors. And
well, actually, I've got a breakfast. It's also a brunch, and it can be a lunch and a dinner. It's probably one of the most flexible meals. Have you ever heard of kedgeree?
Yes, I love kedgeree.
I've got one for you.
Ooh.
Oh, yes. First on today.
So, breakfast, obviously, we need a Bloody Mary.
This is the greatest place on earth. Can I just work here?
Yeah. Oh, that'll sort you out, won't it?
Wow. That looks outrageously delicious. I really want to eat that egg so perfectly poached in a bag. Your bondage egg.
My bondage egg. So I think I'm going to rename them. Mm,
that is so delicious. Mmm, so good.
Do
we have to share some of them? That's my grandmother and me. I should offer everyone else some for myself.
That is lovely.
I could have a little more of this bloody
Mary. Go for it.
Have you ever been a waitress?
No.
Think of yourself like a car saleswoman.
Okay.
Turn it around that way.
Is it very hot?
No, you can hold that, yeah.
This is also real.
Yeah, go for it.
Go on.
You guys can smell.
Delicious.
Mm. I'm going to put it down here. This is kedgeree, so it's rice and poached eggs.
Oh, my God. It's amazing.
It smells fulfilling without even eating it, I think.
This is delicious. It tastes so good.
You could have this after a hangover, couldn't you? That'd be lovely in the morning.
I thought kedgeree was a vegetable.
So, with your lovely family, is there any foods that they absolutely love, any types of cuisine?
Our big boys, Gray and Milo. Milo's obsessed with ramen right now. And Gray is obsessed with dumplings, like dim sum and shumai. But I actually don't know how to make Asian food.
Right, so their favourite food, you can't actually make
them. I know, yeah.
Well, how lucky for you, we've got a cooking lesson of a lifetime coming up.
We found an amazing little setup. It's a really lovely story. So this is Chef Ningma, and she's got a lovely restaurant called Mamalan. And it's in Brixton Market. When she came over from China, she really, really missed her food. But actually, she comes from a family that have always cooked. So this is her mum.
Sweet.
And they were street food vendors in Beijing, and they would make all of the dumplings in their house, in the front room, then they'd go out and they'd sell them all, and they had some bestsellers. So I've got two recipes to teach you.
No right.
One is really easy to make, and you can fry it, and it's delicious. And then the other one is a prawn dumpling. You like prawn?
They're my favorite ones. But if I know how to make them, I want to eat them all the time.
That's fine, you can do that.
Gray's going to be
I've studied
happy.
It. So are you ready for this lovely
I'm
girl?
So ready.
We're going to get a penny on you, and let's get cooking.
Here in our Southend cafe, we have Hollywood's favourite elf, Liv Tyler, bringing her magic.
Cheers.
Cheers. Can I just work here?
And right now, Liv is getting to grips with making dim sum dumplings that will hopefully earn gold stars with her kids back home.
This is our moment together. Are you excited?
Very excited.
OK, we're going to make the dumpling dough.
Okay.
We're going to add a flour called dumpling flour.
Okay.
And you'll be able to get this in Asian supermarkets.
Okay.
So 250 grams of dumpling flour. We're going to use 130 millilitres of warm water. So you see it in Italy as well with pasta sometimes. They'll use warm water and they'll get a much more stretchy dough.
I've always sort of shied away from crusts and doughs. And
really?
I can make like an apple, I call it a crisp, but you call it crumble. But
yes.
I've always wanted to understand about the secrets of dough.
Yeah, okay. It's not hard. Can you see I'm just kneading it, pulling it back? If you look at it now, see how the texture's just changed?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's really hot.
Yeah. So we're going to wrap this dumpling dough up like that in a little bit of cling film. And when it relaxes, then it becomes more pliable so you can kind of wrap things in it and do all those lovely shapes and sizes. Now, over here, what do you see in front of you?
Sweet, adorable prawns.
Yes. You are a prawn lover, aren't you?
I do like prawns.
What is it about prawns that you love?
No, they're just very delicious. I don't love seeing their sweet heads and little legs, but...
We're going to squeeze the head off.
Off with his head. Oh, boy.
We're going to go off with the shell. And we'll just squeeze it out like that.
It really doesn't take long to prep prawns. Once done, chop up a third quite finely, whilst leaving the rest chunky.
And then we can bring it all together. Here we've got water chestnuts. We chop those up as well, nice texture. The spring onions here, again, finely slicing these. About a thumb-sized piece of ginger. What we're gonna do is just mix this together. They use one egg to bind it together.
Now zing this up with some white pepper, a splash of sesame oil, and if you can get it, Shaoxing rice wine.
And I think if you can't find it, you could use some rice
it's
wine.
It's like
vinegar.
A vinegar? Okay.
Yeah. You want a teaspoon of that, so we mix this together. Are you a lover of spicy food?
I am. I do like spicy very much.
I heard that one of my spicy dishes might have sent you into labour a little bit early. Is this true? Is that true?
The island stew?
Yeah. Really?
I made it on the night that I went into, yes, with Milo, with my first son.
That's amazing. In some part, I was with you at the beginning of your labour.
Let's hope for a little less drama today. Our filling is finished with some vegetable oil and a pinch of salt.
Are you cool to have a go at doing that yourself?
I'm very cool.
Your ingredients for the dough are here.
Oh, I have to do everything.
And the filling here. And
dough too? We might need a cocktail for this.
I'm going to give you a glass of wine. And I want you just to forget that there's 30 people that are really hungry.
And try not to get really pissed and chop my finger off.
Yeah. Liv Tyler, welcome.
God, this
Good
is
luck
so
with
stressful.
The dough. Yeah. Oh, it's not stressful. You're all right.
I'm really scared about the dough part. I feel like he didn't use all the water. Never really done pastry before. Okay, he did that. Oh, my God, this is so hard. What seriously. Okay, prawns, I'm ready for you.
Liv has a serious cooking job to get done here.
I actually really like a chestnut. I might have to taste one.
Whilst Jamie and I get thinking about our next food fight.
Who loves lamb chops? Okay. Who actually eats mutton? No, you see?
Well, can we get mutton to dress up as lamb? To see what our calf thinks, I've knocked up some incredible mutton chops with a peanut sauce.
This looks amazing.
It does smell so good. It's really lovely.
Mm. Yeah.
It's
really nice.
Oh, that's delicious. Mm.
Really tender, beautiful.
Mm. I would happily eat that all day, every day.
Yeah. It's so tasty, though.
It's delicious.
Mm-mm.
Wow, that's beautiful.
So what we want you to do, Liv, is go down your local butcher's and say, can I have some mutton, please, big boy?
Yeah.
And see what he gives you.
Yeah. Bit more work.
More chopping, off I go, OK.
Coming up, Liv shows me how to handle her dumplings.
Miss Tyler just did a better one than me.
And I design a build that will cater for everyone. Here in our Southend Caf, I'm teaching blockbuster actress Liv Tyler how to make dim sum dumplings from an original Beijing street recipe. Liv has already tackled the pastry and finished making the filling.
We are at the next stage, and what we can do now is roll this out into our little dumplings. Roll this up like this. I'm just going to cut off little nuggets. So we're going to make it into a little circle. Now we've got this.
Okay.
What we do is we take a little brush.
Is that just water?
Just water. And we'll take your, well, my filling, but you take either of them, and you just fill that in the middle like that, and then we're just going to fold it over. This is when you want that stretchiness from the dough. Can you see that?
That's beautiful.
But once you've done that, you sit it like that. And then the recipe from this family is literally as simple as that. Which one do you want to have a go at? Rolling or folding?
Yes, I want to roll.
But would your kids like doing this?
If they knew that a dumpling was at the end of end of all. This is like kind of everyday food, right?
Yeah,
this is like making a bacon sandwich, right?
Absolutely.
Amazing.
We could start a little dumpling shop.
My shape is going all wonky over here.
Yours, I think, wonky's amazing. Nice. I've spent a life being a bit wonky. You know.
What's the key to making a not wonky?
If you don't want to be wonky, just turn a little piece of pastry and don't turn your rolling pin.
Got it.
While Jamie and...
Do you know what dim sum actually means?
No, I was going to ask you that before, but I didn't want to sound silly.
Touch the heart.
No way.
Yeah, it means it translates as touch the heart.
What?
And I know, isn't that emotional? One of the nice things about dim sum is all the different shapes and sizes.
Yeah,
and
I made a little wave like a shell.
Yours is better than mine. Oh, my Lord. Miss Tyler just did a better one than me. OK. It's looking up, guys. It's looking up. That is a beautiful one. It looks like a little mini Cornish pasty. You've done a great job. But you know what's going to happen now, don't you?
Oh, you're going to leave me and I'm going to make all the dumplings for the whole restaurant. What?
Girl.
They're not that hungry.
No, we're hungry.
Do you want to come help me? It might take a minute. We've only got not very many here.
There's something special about wood-fired food that I think our diners will love.
This kebab has like a rainbow of colours on it. This looks great.
Just the taste is so different, isn't it? You can't beat it.
I like the crunchiness of the outside of the flatbread, but the softness of the filling inside.
Mm-hmm. It'd be great to have a wood-fired oven at home, wouldn't it?
I would love to, yeah.
It's what summers are made for.
Okay.
Liv, come over here. We've got more food for you.
Wow,
so we've got lovely gosame here, and we've got some wonderful kebabs. On this oven, you can make pizzas, make bread.
Really good.
Can I dip in?
Have a little dip in.
I was going to do that. You beat me to that.
Look at that. Still loads of cooking to do.
Oh.
Look how good they are, Jim.
She is magic in the kitchen.
Still to come, we find out if Liv will deliver her dumplings on time. Here in our caf on Southend Pier, actress Liv Tyler has brought a sprinkling of gunpowder to today's plot.
We might need a cocktail for this.
I'm teaching Liv to cook dim sum from incredible family recipes given to us by Chinese chef Ning Ma. The first is prepared.
Wow, look at how beautiful that is.
But I've got one more.
We were given another recipe by this gorgeous girl's great-grandfather.
Wow.
Okay? It's celebrating vegetables. It's like a Chinese onion bhaji.
Take coriander, ginger, cooked vermicelli noodles, spring onion and grated carrot.
Look at the different textures.
and add a little Chinese five spice, white pepper, self-raising flour, water and sea salt.
Apparently this was so popular on their street stall that people used to come and buy it by the kilo.
Amazing.
So what we do is we then take little amounts like this, and they specifically say don't be too perfect.
When you fry it, is that what you said?
It just goes crazy. It looks like my hair in the morning, basically.
Deep fry these little beauties until golden and crisp.
So can you see how they're kind of cool because they're not perfect? They're kind of gnarly and twisted. And then we have the chili sauce, which is what they said to have with it. Have a little chunk, but that crunch on the outside. Yeah, you can do the whole thing if you want.
Wow. Okay, I better hurry up and make them for them.
Liv's other dim sum, her prawn and water chestnut dumplings are now ready for cooking.
And we're gonna just begin to fry their bottoms. Talking about bottoms. aren't you working with lingerie designer?
I've never modeled lingerie in my life and also just had my baby and I was like, what? And I'm going to be 40 soon. I don't know. It just sounded like a good challenge and sort of fun. So I did that.
Okay, let's concentrate.
We're frying bottoms here.
Yeah. So having just a fried bottom is no good for anyone. We need to steam. We need that softness, that silkiness.
The original recipe we were given just uses water, but I've added a spoonful of flour to it. A really cool little trick that I think you're going to love.
Floury water goes in. About a centimetre.
Steam the dumplings with the lid on, and as the water evaporates, a little bit of elvish magic happens in the pan.
Oh my God, it really did it. Oh.
That little extra flour has formed the coolest crispy wings to the dumplings.
Really, really beautiful. And you can kind of take it apart and just let it kind of click.
Amazing.
But look how truly beautiful that is.
Serve them with a little chili oil and some Chinese vinegar.
Look at that!
I like a little spice, I'm going
a little, not too much. Not enough to send you into labour again, hopefully. It's not.
Oh, my.
Good? And don't be afraid to double dip. We can double dip in our culture.
You can do anything at the end of the pier.
Oh, that noise that just come out of your mouth. Sound like a mating walrus.
It's like Gandalf being scolded.
You happy?
I'm really happy.
You got to feed that, love.
OK, get to it.
While Liv cooks up her balls of joy for the whole calf...
Good luck, girl.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Jamie and I have a food fight. Back in Southend, two of our calendar pin-up farmers, Yasmin and Richard, have popped in.
I mean, the big question for me is, since it's got a little bit colder, have you put any more clothes on?
No.
Unless one of us has.
Let's have a look at what we've produced.
Liv.
Yeah.
Come and have a look at this tiger.
Oh, wow.
At your calendar. Okay. Look at the back. Look at the back.
This is our naked calendar.
That, I mean, that is a thing of beauty.
Look at the belly on that. Look at the...
He's eating a lot of mutton.
It was cold that day.
It was.
That's my favourite one, boys. Mutton and rump.
This is a bit of fun, but you can download this from our website, right? And the whole idea is to really push the diversity of different sheep meat we've got out there.
Farming is hard enough already.
Yeah.
We want young people going into it. We want them to thrive and succeed. And by you guys getting more value for your mutton means that your businesses are much more sustainable.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you think this is going to help sell it?
I hope so.
It might put people off.
Yeah. If you want it signed, give me a shout.
Lovely job.
Liv, I think you've got to get back to your dumplings.
Liv has mastered her veggie dim sum, and the prawn and water chestnut dumplings are smashing.
Yes. Every time she knocks it out, she seems to be getting slightly more and more dominant in her technique. Yours is better than mine. Everything that you do today is better than me. Thank you very much. Right, who wants some of this?
Dim sum is so yummy.
So good.
That crunch and then a softness. Wouldn't mind if Liv just cooks us some more and I could take them away.
That's great.
This is the best dumpling I ever ate in the UK.
We just knew that with Liv cooking in our calf, today was going to be a bit special.
Liv Tyler, everyone. How incredible. You did so well.
Amazing.
So well.
Amazing. Well done.